Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum to everyone. I am Zubia Akram from Vijay Public School and Inter College Sahiwal. I will teach you biology class first year. Objectives. By the end of this lesson, students will be able to understand absorption of a food, structure and function of villi in digestion, parts of a large intestine and their function in digestion, some common diseases related to nutrition. So dear students, in your previous class, you have studied about digestion in small intestine. As you have studied that, there are main three parts of small intestine, which are duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Duodenum, which is 20 to 25 cm long. The chyme pass from stomach into duodenum. And the second one, jejunum, which is 2.4 cm long. It extends from duodenum to the ileum. And the last one, ileum, the lower 3/5 of the small intestine forms ileum. So dear students, the digestion of food is completed in the jejunum and ileum. Today we will discuss about the absorption of a food in ileum. So dear student, nearly all the absorption of products of a digestion takes place in the ileum. First of all, we will discuss about the structure of ileum. First of all, we will see villi. The internal surface of the ileum has finger-like outgrowth called villi, as you can see in this diagram. The villi give velvety appearance to the inner wall of the ileum, as you can see. Each villi is composed of three parts. These parts are blood capillaries, lepthyl, and epithelial cells. These all parts can be seen in this diagram. These are blood capillaries. This one, lepthyl. And these are epithelial cells. Now we will discuss the function of a villi. Blood capillaries. Villi are richly supplied with blood capillaries. Blood capillaries absorb glucose and amino acids. And the next, lepthyl. Villi have a vessel called lepthyl. The lepthyl is a part of lymphatic system. It absorbs fatty acids and glycerols. And the last one, epithelium or epithelial cells. Villi are covered with a covering of epithelial cells, as you can see in this diagram. Epithelial cells of the villi are constantly shed into intestine. And they increase the surface area for absorption. The next one is microvilli. Epithelial cells of the villi have closely packed cylindrical processes called microvilli. Actually students, the total area for the absorption is increased due to villi and microvilli. The absorption of different compounds takes place in these structures. These compounds are sugar and amino acids and fats. So the absorption of these compounds takes place by following processes. The absorption of sugar and amino acids by diffusion and active transport. Actually, students, the blood in capillaries of the villi absorb sugar and amino acids by diffusion or active transport. The second one, absorption of fats by the blood. Some of the fatty acids and glycerols are also absorbed by the blood. However, a large amount of the fatty acids and glycerol enters into epithelial cells of the villi. Following process takes place in the absorption of fats. Now we will discuss these processes one by one. First of all, entry of fatty acids and glycerols. Fatty acids and glycerols enters into epithelial cells. And the second one, recombination of fatty acids and glycerols. In this process, the fatty acids and glycerols recombine to form fats in these cells. Then entry of fats into lacteals. These fats then enter into lacteal. Some proteins are also present in lacteals. These proteins combine with the fats molecule to form lipoprotein droplets. Then transportation of lipoprotein droplets. The droplets are transferred into blood vessels through lymphatic duct. Then hydrolyzation of droplets. These lipoprotein droplets are hydrolyzed by the blood plasma enzymes. Then they enter the body cells. These fats may be used in the respiration or stored as a fat in the liver or in the muscles of the underskin. So in this way, absorption of fats is completed. The next one is transport of food through ileum. Actually, students, in this process, the intestinal contents are pushed along the alimentary canal by normal peristaltic activity. There is a leucolic sphincter, as you can see in this diagram, at the end of the ileum. This sphincter opens from time to time and allows a small amount of residue food to enter into large intestine. So in this way, we have completed our first objective, which is absorption of food. Now we will start our second objective, which is a large intestine. The parts of a large intestine are cecum, colon, and rectum. Now we will discuss these parts and their function one by one. First of all, we will see cecum. It is a blind sac. The cecum is a blind sac. It projects from large intestine between ileum and colon, as you can see in this figure. A finger-like process arises from the blind end of the cecum, which is called appendix. As you can see in this figure, this is appendix. Sometimes food entraps in the appendix. The decay of this food causes inflammation of appendix. The inflammation of appendix is called appendicitis. In some cases, such inflamed appendix has to be removed surgically. The next one is a colon. It is the largest part. Colon opens into a rectum. It is further divided into three parts, which are ascending part, transverse part, and descending part. These all parts can be seen in this diagram. The next one is rectum. It is the last part of large intestine. This is the temporary store in it. So, dear student, finally, these feces are removed through the anus at intervals. Anus is surrounded by two sphincter, as you can see in this diagram. The internal is a smooth sphincter, while the outer sphincter has stripped muscles. As the rectum fills with the feces, it gives rise to defecation reflex. This reflex can be controlled in adults, but it can't be controlled in children. The next one, function of large intestine. Large intestine perform the following functions, which are absorption of water and salts. So, dear students, the mineral that passes from small intestine to large intestine has a large amount of water, dissolved salts, undigested material. Most of the water and salts are absorbed into blood. There can be two abnormalities in the absorption of water, which are diarrhea and constipation. Diarrhea. If the absorption of water does not take place, it causes diarrhea. Diarrhea may be caused due to infection, drug action, emotional disturbances. If the diarrhea remains unchecked, it may cause dehydration. Such condition may be fatal. And the next one, constipation. It is an other extreme condition. In this case, excessive water is absorbed. Second function of large intestine is synthesis of vitamins. A large population of bacteria lives in the large intestine. These bacteria synthesize some vitamins, especially vitamin K. Vitamin K is absorbed by the blood and used in the body. And the next one, removal of feces. The feces are also removed by large intestine through anus. This is contained a large number of bacteria, plant fibers, mucus, cholesterol, bile pigments, and water. So, dear students, in this way we have completed large intestine and their function. Now we will discuss about some common diseases related to nutrition. These diseases are dyspepsia, food poisoning, and ulcer. First of all, we will discuss about dyspepsia, incomplete digestion. So, dear students, incomplete or imperfect digestion is called dyspepsia. This is not a disease itself. It is a symptom of the other disorder or a disease. The symptoms of dyspepsia are abnormal discomfort, flatulence, heartburn, nausea, and vomiting. Heartburn is a condition where some of stomach contents are forced back into esophagus. Nausea, the sensation of wanting to vomit. The next one, causes of dyspepsia. Excessive acidity. Dyspepsia may occur due to excessive acidity in the stomach. It is also caused by faculty function of stomach and intestine. And it is also caused due to insufficient quantity and quality of bile secretion. And the next one, food poisoning. The illness from indigestion of food containing toxic substances is called food poisoning. Symptoms are diarrhea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. The next one, causes of disease. Common food poisoning is caused by bacteria which are Salmonella, Campylobacter. These bacteria produce toxin which cause this disease. These bacteria live in the intestine of a cattle, chicken, and duck. They don't cause any disease in these animals. Human can develop food poisoning if they drink milk, eat meat, or egg contaminated with these bacteria. And the next one, botulism. Botulism, it is a severe form of food poisoning. It is caused by toxin produced by the bacteria called Clostridium botulinum. Botulism is developed by improperly canned or preserved food like a meat. The toxins produced by these bacteria are very powerful. It has selective action on central nervous system. It can cause respiratory diseases or infections. Symptoms are fatigue, dizziness, double vision, and vomiting. The next disease is ulcer. This over in the inner wall of the digestive tract is called ulcer. The inner wall of the digestive tract is covered with a mucus, as we have studied in our previous classes. Mucus protects the inner membrane from the action of enzyme. When the mucus layer is broken, the digestive enzyme start eating the wall of the stomach and duodenum. This results in the so-called ulcer. Symptoms are heartburn, nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. Prevention. The patient of ulcer should avoid smoking, spicy food, alcoholic beverages, and stress. So, dear student, in this way we have completed our today's topic. Now we will discuss some MCQs which are related to our today's topic. Let's see the MCQ number 1. The internal surface of the ileum has a finger-like outgrowth called option A, lacule, option B, villi, option C, epithelial cells, option D, lumen. So the correct answer is option B. MCQ number 2. The protein molecule combined with the fats to form option A, lipoprotein, option B, fatty acids, option C, glycerol, option D, amino acids. So we have studied about fats. MCQ number 3. DASH is produced in the large intestine and absorbed by the blood and juice in the body. Option A, vitamin B. Option B, vitamin K. Option C, vitamin C. Option D, vitamin E. We have studied about it in the large intestine. So the correct answer is option B, vitamin K. And the last MCQ is, defecation reflex arises in Option A, Cologne. Option B, Ratnam. Option C, Sikkim. Option D, Lal Hindustan. So the correct answer is Ratnam, option B. So dear student, there are some short questions which are related to our today's topic. Question number 1, what is botulism? Question number 2, what is ulcer? Question number 3, how fats are absorbed in our life? Question number 4, what are the causative agents of food poisoning? So dear students, I hope today's lesson will help you to understand absorption of a food, large intestine, and some common diseases related to nutrition. Thank you.